that I have, and then also people that follow me on Facebook. So yeah, loads of opportunity. I'm just working and reeling it in.
Think big, but act small.
Yep.
What does a small business do? Does a small business, you think big. I want a lot of clients. I want to grow my business. I want to have multiple streams of income. I want to pay off debt, be debt-free, mortgage-free, and everything. And then think small. What does a small business do? They watch their overhead.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They watch their overhead. Does overhead kill a lot of businesses? How many businesses are in the red before they're in the black?
Yeah.
Okay. Can keep your overhead, keep your overhead low and your profits high. I have no employee. I'm proud to say this. Good morning, Jess.
I got it. I've got an ego. I've got a control here. I have to have the offices and the shiny truck and all and all the 15, people, and then the organic coffee. Like, so what about the ego though? Is it okay that I go in the negative and I have a big ego?
You can run, this is America. You can do whatever the hell you want, but what was that? The Millionaire Next Door. Anybody ever read that book?
Okay. He's got a screen door that creaks.
What do super? I just spoke. Somebody has noise. John, do you have something to say or?
Oh, just The Millionaire Next Door.
Yeah, great book.
Great book.
Mom and pops who run little grocery stores and dry cleaners and things like that. Okay. What was my story when we first started? For those of you who came in late, I talked about a man, 78 years old, Vietnam vet, started a little limo business with one car in North Carolina. Okay. Now he has a fleet of cars, of limos and cars and SUVs. He's got a bunch of drivers. He owes nothing. And he's making a close to $400,000 net a year. Net. Okay. One little guy doing a great business. Okay. So I understand the ego about the office and the employees and everything like that. It's just whatever floats your boat. This is a subjective perspective here. Okay. I'd rather have a business with no employees. I've had employees. Okay. This is my take on it. You can disagree. I'm a great boss. I fetch my employees coffee. I get them. I pay them over market. I want to pay people generously. And they were still a pain in the ass. Okay. And I just got to the point where I said, you know what? Maybe I'll take on a little bit more. I'll try to work smarter and more succinct. I'll try to streamline my business where I'm just, where do you think closing in the first phone call came from? Okay. I know there's a lot of guys talking, well, you got to have your acquisition manager, your VAs, all that overhead, and then the office. I had a nice office and everything like that. But you know what I found out in the old days before Zoom and everything? I used to meet people in coffee shops and stuff like that. Okay. Or for lunch or for dinner or something like that. Real nice, or hotels, a lot of hotel meetings. Really good environment. And you know what? All of a sudden, I got rid of a $3,500 in those days. It's probably $7,000 now a month office. Okay. Well, guess what happens when you get rid of a $3,000-$5,000 a month overhead, and you multiply that by 1 year. That's $60,000 maybe you have now to invest into something else.
I can relate with that tremendously.